Okay, what about the table up there? You're sitting quietly. Is it differentiated? Yeah. But in fact, it's very likely with this kind of situation, what you've got are three tasks, and everyone is doing identical tasks, yeah? Yeah, virtually, yeah. Sorry? Well, I don't know. You could write in whatever the teacher's doing. I don't know. They might be just roaming. Maybe they've pulled out kids to do something or other else on the floor. Kids that can't do whatever happened on the first lesson. Yeah. Maybe they're reading the paper. Now. No. Okay. How could I differentiate? I mean, some people use this model. Leanne's just asked what's the teachers doing, and I'm not sure you could have the teacher doing whatever they do. Teachers could perhaps in this case decide after they've done the whole class lesson thing that there's a bunch of kids who are struggling with that, and it may be that the teachers pulled some kids off over here and they're doing stuff with the teacher while the rest of their gang continues to rotate around. Something jumped into my head then about games, yeah, because somebody said, oh, that was Leanne again. This sounds like a secondary model. No, it's not. I've seen this done in lots of primary schools where there's kids over there playing a game, kids over there doing Lego, kids doing the computer, kids doing a worksheet, and maybe kids with the teacher doing something or other. Now, issues here for me, all those things are supposed to be connected to whatever it is that we're doing, and it sometimes falls down because there is a lot of work in doing this and making sure that every one of those is differentiated as well within that. That's why be very wary of teachers saying, yes, I differentiate because the kids rotate around different, you know, I cater for different learning styles. That doesn't mean that my tasks are differentiated. Differentiated mean there's hard, easy, and middle kind of levels of business going on there. And so once I get onto the concrete investigation challenge, I need not just one challenge, but I'll need like three versions of that challenge. The Mathletics can adjust itself up or down, but if I've got anything else, rainforest maths or something or other, I have to find out where do I locate the kids. And the worksheets, I need hard, easy and medium worksheets as well. So that they're, for teachers to be doing this one, they need to put in quite a lot of work as a team to make sure that that works. I'm not saying it won't work, you just need to be very clear. Differentiated doesn't mean different tasks that everybody finishes up doing. Okay. Now, how could a professional learning team help if they've decided that's the model they want, or if some higher body at the school decides that at our school that's what we do, our kids rotate round, you know, activity stations or whatever you like to call them. How could a professional learning team help if that's the situation they're in and there's that much work to do? Okay, yeah, we've got lots of chattering on, but that's, you know, when a professional learning team goes into wherever they go with the jelly beans and the cake, if they know that this is the way that they work at their school or the way that they intend to work or they're happy working, but they also get the message about differentiation, then perhaps one of the team, or however big the team is, a third of the team need to handle the easy version of everything. And a third of the team need to work out the middle version, and a third of the team the top version. That actually wouldn't work for me. I'd have to say one group do easy, medium, hard of the concrete. Yeah, that's right. One do easy, medium, hard of the blah, blah, blah. So before they set foot into the planning room, you know, make sure that those things are clear in their head, that when you go in there, you're going to come out with differentiated stuff, not different tasks, differentiated work within whatever the tasks are you're doing. Okay, now, so that's my interpretation, my understanding of when I've gone around the state, they tend to be the models that teachers are using, other than some are still doing just whole class the whole time, and sometimes a lesson calls for that. The next thing, and it's not rocket science, that teachers need to do when they go into the planning room with the jelly beans, they pull out your fantastic scope and sequence that you've got at your school up there, and they look at everything that they're, and pull out everything on that that they're going to focus on for term one, whatever term it is. Here they all are listed down in a very nice way. This was some school, can't remember who they are, that I went to, and the teachers were very focused on, there it is in black and white on one page, level one, this term, that's what we're doing. This could then be coloured in back on your scope and sequence that was your whole annual planner, so that I can see in the one, well, yours goes for about three pages, I can see what we've done for term one. Not rocket science, but you know, people need to get the plan happening. There's the year's work. Here we've pulled out and identified exactly what we're doing term one. Now, if I decide that I'm going to, for me, I'm going to focus on, or our team, we're actually, for the first week, we've got that five lesson thing. Are we doing number, number, number? Are we going to do number, 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 other investigation, number, you know, whatever the combination is. And I've worked out that I've actually got, what have I got here? I've written it down. I'm going to do, probably I'll do two lessons here. It'll take me to cover the stuff there in space, and it'll probably take me a couple of lessons, maybe three lessons for the measurement and data. I'm doing lots of the time stuff, incidentally, might only be a day. It's quite an easy conversation to have, to sit around just talking about they're the things we're doing and how long am I going to be doing some of those things. The data, well, we actually knocked that off. We're going to knock that off in the first 2 weeks while we're doing this love stuff over here, whatever it's called, you know, it's community, same drift. And so, and I can see there our big focus is on number, which is exactly how we had hoped it would be. So I've picked out, we've picked out for the next fortnight, what are those things we're going to focus on? And for the whole term in number, for example, what are we focusing on? There it is. And I need, as a team, with my team, to work out now some pre and post assessment stuff. Again, I don't know if it was this mob or the other mob last week, about the fantastically simple activity that someone came up with. All their year three kids at the start of the year are given last year's NAP plan thing as a pre-test, NAP plan test, and all their year fives at the start of the year are given last year's year five NAP plan test. Just get it down off the web. And teachers identify, it's not teaching to the test, it's identifying the fact that, my God, we don't do enough space. My God, these kids haven't got a clue about place value. It's not teaching to the test, it's finding out which parts of the curriculum there are few issues with. So I'll work out with my team, what are we going to accept as pre and post assessment? Are we going to have the same thing on either side? You'll have your own feeling about that. I think for me, make it as simple as you can, because that's the kind of gal I am. You might do one of these concept maps where the kids are asked, this is a year 5-6 kid that doesn't need to do anything about fractions. So the teacher can put him straight into year 7 now. You might do something like that, or you might, as a team, have a look at the progression points and all the documentation, the learnings, focus statements, even all your Nelson textbooks. Have a look and see, is there a test thing that you may be able to use given the topic you're going to do. You want something, my speaking again, quick and dirty for the fortnight's worth of work or the 3 weeks, something that will get you an answer about where are the kids up to. You know, anything that goes over more than a lesson, or even takes up a whole 1 hour lesson, to me is a huge assessment task. Kids conk out by about halfway through anyway.